Evolved from the dinosaurs. In fact, we're given a lot of evidence for this alleged fact. Now, just how good is that evidence? Did you unwittingly have T-Rex for dinner last night and think it tasted an awful lot like chicken? Or is avian evolution for the birds?
How's it going, eh?
First thing I'd like to point out is the assumption that evolution is true, and the assumption that birds evolved from dinosaurs, and thus the impact that has on the interpretation of the evidence. For example, when we head on over to the ever-so-reliable Wikipedia, we find out that the definition between dinosaur and bird has been blurred.
A majority of modern paleontologists reject the traditional style of classification in favor of phylogenetic nomenclature, which requires that all descendants of a single common ancestor must be included in a group for that group to be natural. Birds are thus considered by most modern scientists to be dinosaurs, and dinosaurs are therefore not extinct. Birds are classified by most paleontologists as belonging to the subgroup Maniraptora, which are coelurosaurs, which are theropods, which are saurischians, which are dinosaurs.
Well, isn't that convenient? If it isn't a bird, call it a bird anyway. Look, just because you call a dinosaur a bird does not make it a bird.
Want some? Oh, sorry.
Using that kind of logic, it's just as logical to call a lion a dog. It is just as outrageous to call a dinosaur a bird as it is to call the duck-billed platypus a bird. Theorists will point out similarities or homologies between the structures of the birds and the dinosaurs. However, they will only point out the similarities that they seem to want you to know about.
For example, the saurischian dinosaurs are so named because of their lizard-like hips. Saur for lizard, ischian for hip. The saurischians include dinosaurs like the T-Rex and the Apatosaurus. Some have feet similar to birds, others have feet like an elephant. Some have small arms, others have four large legs. They all have hips like a lizard. Then there's the ornithischians, orna for bird, ischian for hip. They are so named because they have hips like a bird. The ornithischians include dinosaurs like the hadrosaurs. Some have feet similar to birds, some even have a bill like a duck, and they all have hips similar to a bird. Now, which of these groups do you think the birds would evolve from? The saurischians or the ornithischians? You probably guessed the ornithischians, but the Dino de Bird theorists picked the saurischians.
Obviously, homology is a useless tool for evolution. The Dino de Bird theorists only use it when they think it supports their case, and ignore it when it doesn't support their evolutionary assumptions. I cover the failure of homology in CrEvo Rant number 2. Now, what about those dinosaurs evolving feathers? Aren't those dinosaurs that are evolving into birds? First of all, you need to understand these dinosaurs weren't found with feathers. They were found with organic artifacts that were interpreted to be proto-feathers, the precursor of the feather. Right? But wait! The evolutionary sequence is backwards! Archaeopteryx had fully formed feathers, while Bapiosaurus, Sinoceropteryx, and Shuvuya had proto-feathers. According to the evolutionary timescale, the dinosaurs then were de-evolving feathers. Other evolutionary experts have suggested that the dinosaurs who did have feathers were just simply flightless birds. Other fossils have been found which look just like modern birds, Protoavis, for example, he looks just like the modern blackbird. But that fossil was considered controversial. Why? Because it was found in the Texas Triassic, which according to the evolutionary timescale, was before the dinosaurs. Obviously, you cannot be your grandfather's father. So we got a problem here. Yeah. Wait a minute! Fossils aren't controversial. Fossils are just fossils. They're dead things. The only thing controversial here is evolutionary theory. Here in Canada, the fossil footprints of a wading bird was found in Carboniferous rocks, but Sternberg wrote in 1933 that there was little possibility of these having been made by wading birds. Why? Because the rocks the footprints were found in were Carboniferous, and according to evolutionary theory, birds had not yet evolved. Wait a minute here. This is not controversial. Evolutionary theory is controversial, and it doesn't line up with the fossil evidence. So completely modern fossil birds were found in rocks older than the dinosaurs. And if we take the fossil evidence at face value, the dinosaurs, if anything, were de-evolving feathers, the opposite of evolution. When confronted with these facts, the Dino de Bird theorists then pull a complete about face and claim that no, these weren't dinosaurs evolving into birds, they were sister species which became extinct. They didn't quite make it. What a convenient story that is. The fossil dinosaurs that were found were actually found with fossil hair-like structures, which many evolutionary scholars interpreted to be collagen fibers from decaying flesh, and not proto-feathers at all. In fact, according to a Royal Society article, a fossil ichthyosaur was found with the same hair-like structures. An ichthyosaur can be best described as a marine dinosaur that looks an awful lot like a dolphin. So, are we going to claim that a dolphin-like creature also evolved into birds? So it turns out the only evidence that dinosaurs evolved into birds was based on the assumption that dinosaurs evolved into birds and using that assumption to interpret the evidence. The evidence isn't controversial, the theory of evolution is controversial. Creation in a young Earth, however, has no conflict with the evidence, which has birds being created about 6,000 years ago. Well, if the Bible's right about that, what else is it right about? The Bible says that this earth has been corrupted by the sin of mankind, and thus God is going to destroy this heaven and earth and make a new heaven and new earth. The problem is he can't allow even one drop of sin into that new heaven and new earth. Otherwise, it would corrupt it as well. So we got a problem. This is where the Lord Jesus Christ comes in, who lived a perfect, sinless life and died in place of sinners like you and I. And that allows us to be seen in the sight of God as sinless. And Christ has provided a free way for us into the new heaven and new earth. But you must give him your life in exchange. Why don't you give him your life today?